going on, y'all? Remy here, finally getting back to the channel. Gonna be posting some content for you guys once I get some things in order. It's been a pretty tough year for me. Getting back into a job, I've been doing detailing for a while now, at least a year. My wife and I have also been trying to sell our home. So we gotta get everything tidy. We gotta figure out what we're selling, what we're keeping, what we're gonna be taking down there. We are moving to Florida, so it's gonna be a hell of a lot warmer. We're ready for the sun. Detailing is definitely an option down there. And then of course I've got my golf side that you guys have probably seen in some of the other videos and whatnot. I told you guys I would be making a RS7 video after all the videos that you saw of all the things I was putting on the S6, trying to make it easy for you guys. And you know, just sharing the experiences of trying to do DIY stuff. I mean, painting your calipers, putting on badges and all that. It's fun. No further ado, let's check out the auto.
Yeah. That almighty amazing, ill, highly contagious, kamikaze sound splash like a shot from a gauge until your body sound clash. Hit of the class, magna cum laude beats, bring the beat, stop me, flagrant, foul, rowdy, reed pipe, a deep type. Disposition, keep them flipping, keep them playing their position, keep making the people listen what I spent. Put them out on the limb, got tears, got blood, got sweat, leaking out of the pen. Y'all fake niggas not setting the trend, we never listen to them. It's like trying to take a piss in the wind. My home team doing visitors in, yo, don't test them, they all standing close to the edge, so don't stress them. Now who the type? Built the last, it's no question the master. Villain in black with no steps in my sound. Hitting you hard from every direction. Your head and your shoulder, area, your midsection.
When the snare on down with the nine on round, with the net to the rhyme, with King Khan, he the clown, man. Give it here, and don't say nothing, just give it here. And don't say nothing, when the team on the check with the blunt, don't clap, hit the plan, huh? Let the thing, cut the check.
So there she is, guys. She's beautiful. 2016 Audi RS7. She is an absolute machine. I've done some pretty good, okay modifications to her. I've taken out the resonators. I've taken out the center box. I have taken out the OEM wheels, which are very heavy. Put on some BC forged two-piece, exposed rivets hardware, gloss black face, gloss black barrel, 21 inch by 10 ET30. They fit pretty well on the RS7. You can see right there the gap is very nice, especially in dynamic mode. Right now it is in dynamic mode. It will be about like an inch higher or so once in regular comfort mode. I put the lowering links in, which trick the airbags in the car to thinking that it's riding higher than it actually is. They're a really good cheap option, can give you some nice appearance. You know, that wheel back here looks pretty snug when you get down on only about an inch or finger gap. Pretty good. Haven't really done anything to the inside. Let's see here, you know, just normal stuff. Not really needed anything on the interior, as you guys saw from the intro to this thing. But yeah, nothing really needed on the interior. I got these SeaSucker roof racks for it. I think they're pretty darn useful, just for the fact that you can take them right off and right on. There's no scratching of the paint. There's no nothing. Nothing happens to the paint underneath these things. And they're very easy to remove. You just push this little tab in right there, and then it'll pretty much release both sides at the same time. Makes it easier. But yeah, those will come in handy, especially for my move down to Florida. This car and the paint, I just can't get over it, man. It's so good. You know, the camera picks up a lot of blue in it. And like, you know, when I take photos of it and stuff like that, it picks up a lot of blues and purples and stuff. But if you remove those in edits, it looks just fantastic. And in person, it's a very, very nice gray appearance. Very, very stealthy. Quick other modifications with the car. I've tuned it from APR. So it's pushing right now around 670 horsepower, give or take. APR says around 665 or in there, but every engine's different. I also put an air intake in there, and I did my resonator delete and my center box delete. So that should compare out to doing something, you know, else or whatever. You know, there's no real proof of all the air intake, but, excuse my French, but it should give me something, maybe some butt dyno, you know, results and whatnot. It's an absolute machine. I really can't say anything less about it. They are amazing. I'm sure a lot of you guys have seen RS7 videos and reviews out there, but I'm just trying to give you my perspective and what I think about it. Absolute fast machine. It does the quarter mile right now with the tune probably in about 11.1, 11 flat. You'll 0 to 60 is at least 3.2, 3.1 maybe in there. Stock, it's like probably like 3.5, 3.6. I think Audi undersells some of the 0 to 60 times, but hey, that's, you know, that's my own opinion. You know, and a lot of people, other people have said that too, but hey, and you know, whatever. You really can't go wrong with this car. It is everything that you need. It's power, it's sporty, it's luxurious, it's got room. You can literally put anything you want in the backside of this car. So look at this trunk space behind me. Look at that. Look at that, you can fit a freaking table in there. A 7x4 foot table, you know? I got plenty of space in there. They just do the job right. They just do it right. One thing I wanna point out is these little babies I put on right here. Little carbon fiber canards right there. Nothing too aggressive, nothing too, you know, out of the ordinary. I mean, they're all on cars that, you know, are tracked and all that stuff. And they're, you know, they are for flair. And really, I mean, they are used in, you know, time attack races and stuff. You know, for the most part, they just are kind of an appearance thing, especially carbon fiber with how much carbon fiber this thing has. The other thing I want to point out is just the brake size on these things. This is the rear brakes, and they're at least in the 340 to 360 millimeter range. I forget the exact spec, but I mean, they're just amazingly designed brakes. The wavy rotor brakes, to reduce a little bit of weight, you can see they're drilled, so they dissipate heat pretty well. I'm actually about due for probably a brake a brake change out relatively soon here. Here you'll see the front ones. Yeah, much bigger. I believe these are in the 380 to 395 range, somewhere in there. If I'm wrong, you guys can correct me, and I'm sorry I'm not getting the numbers right, but just so you know, they are massive, massive brakes. Everything about this car is so refined and so detailed. I mean, just the hexagonal grille pattern that you can see in the front here is just amazing to look at. It's a pain in the butt to clean, but it's just intricately done, and it's on all the RS models, if you were not aware of that. But usually most Audi guys and enthusiasts of especially the RS7 know about the whole hex grille and also the hex stitching in the seats that are there too. The carbon fiber also is really well done. This is all from factory. This is not an aftermarket grill. You can get the Quattro script emblem, and you can get it without that, and you just won't get the carbon around the outside of it. And you can, I believe, still get the carbon obviously packaged here and on the side fins over there. But you know, here, and that's why I did my little pinstriping, you can see the silver lining right there. The butt is also pretty darn good. A nice big carbon fiber diffuser. I did my little pinstriping just to you know, add that a little taste of my own. I think it goes well, of course, with the matte Daytona gray pearl paint. And if you've seen on the car too, I've got these little cover-ups for the side markers. In the US, we need them, you know, per regulations and all that, but they look hella ugly, so I tape them off. I do have to shut them off, because at night you can still see the light coming through them just a little bit. So the interior in this car is pretty much to die for. I tried to get some nice shots for you in the intro here, but I mean, everything is so refined. The screen pops out here, which I believe I can just hit this and it'll pop right out. And that it does. Let's close this. I think it might, nope, radio still stays on. I did not know that. So I hit that and then it'll go off. Just the whole center console is very well done. The nice carbon fiber here is great. There's plenty of storage in there. I won't open that. There's just tons of junk in there. Here, the cup holders, you know, pretty good. You know, a couple change items in there and whatnot. You know, I put my keys there mostly. This side's good for like a Red Bull can. This side's good for a coffee mug or whatever, or a soda can or soda bottle. I do wish they were, you know, probably the same size would be more useful, but hey, it's all good. The Alcantara and carbon fiber in the door is a huge plus. It looks so good. Micro suede or Alcantara is kind of hard to clean. I mean, you got to use a special product with it. You can't really do much of it because you don't want to mess it up. Here, the pedals, you know, my nice flashy boots, but they're, you know, they're very sporty. You know, they get the job done. You know, pedals are pedals, but you know, obviously this isn't a manual, so no clutch. The steering wheel is very well designed. Nice perforated leather. I love it. It feels great. Non-heated steering wheel option. You get the flat, nice flat bottom there, and then just no heated rear seats. Nice, functional, paddle shifters, easy to use. You know, when you want to get on it manually, in a sense. And the dash is great too. Nice RS7 badge, the ready and off. The ready and off started coming in the 2016 models. Plenty of screen space there. I get my maps on there. And the shifter, the round shifter is great. Much more just versatile. You know, I just gave that a nice rub. But yeah, it's functional, like the paddle shifters, and it looks good.
Oh, lounging in here. It's great. Plenty of space. Nice seats in the back, you know, four-seater, it's fine. I'll just take four around, that's cool. Everything's refined. Everything has its little nuances and niches. Can't go wrong with, I think, any of Audi's C7 lines. The S6 interior looked great. I mean, they're all the same interiors. I mean, the S6 interior looks good. Everything looks good. I really love it. Few cons of this car. It is super heavy. It's 4,500 pounds. So in that sense, you're going to lose power overall. You're going to lose speed, you know, racing some other lighter cars and, you know, that whole yada, 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 jibber jabber, whatever it is. How do I put this right? It really works with the weight to power ratio in this car. I mean, Audi did a very good job of determining how, where to put all the weight in turns and how to manage it with the air suspension system. And oh my goodness, I am blanking on the names of these darn parts. Sway bars, and the stock sway bars do a good job of managing the weight too. It is so much fun. I took this car on the tail of the dragon and just blasted through it. I mean, I was keeping up with some other cars I didn't think I was going to be able to keep up with. It was an amazing time. I recommend you getting down to the tail of dragon if you can. If you don't, that's fine, but definitely take your Audi if you have an RS7 or if you don't have an RS7. Quattro system and all that. I mean, yeah, you can talk about understeer and all that crap, but I mean, just for what they are and the price that you get for them, they're so much fun on twisty roads.
All right, so let's close the doors here. Oh, nice little features, obviously the power trunk. And then a nice feature this thing also has is soft closed doors. Boom, done. I got my keys. Let's turn her on. It's in dynamic, like I said before. One thing I want to point out about dynamic is that I have lowering links in the car to drop it about an inch. If I put it into comfort, it raises the car an extra inch, basically because of the links and what the links are doing to the air suspension system. All right, so brake pushing in, push button start. Nice little rumble. A little bit of a drive here so you guys can get a sense of what this car can do. I'm not really going to get a 0-60 time. I still have my summer tires on right now, so getting all the grip and stuff and me potentially sliding out, just I don't really want to do that. So I'll step on a little bit. You can see the pull, the G's. All right, so while I'm just sitting here, I gotta let her warm up just a little bit. You know, I don't really want to push her too hard while she's cold. I've been sitting about 2 hours now since I've been trying to go over the car with you guys. It comes with the ZF8 transmission. They are solid transmissions. They can hold a lot of power. They do well with distributing the power into different gears and all that jibber jabber. But anyways, it's a solid transmission. It's also in my SQ5 that I just picked up for my wife in November. Another thing that kind of, I guess, is pretty important about this car is that the options that you can get with it. DRC is the non-air suspension ride that you can get on this car, and it is supremely harsh, especially for the New Jersey and New York area roads. Air suspension is definitely more floaty, can handle some of the potholes better and not just make you feel like you hit, like, I don't know, a giant boulder or something. I don't know. The air suspension for this car is definitely better, especially in these areas of Jersey and New York, like I said. But if you're in like warmer areas, the DRC is an amazing part of this car. The other big thing that you can get with this car is the Akrapovic exhaust system.
It's rebranded to Audi Sport, but it's a very, very expensive option that you can get. But it's not all that. I mean, yes, my exhaust modifications have helped the sound of the V8. An exhaust would be fine, would be a better option since it's a bit larger diameter. There's really not too many negative things about this car. Like I said before, kind of going over it, the weight is the only real issue in this car. It checks all the boxes. We've let the car warm up enough. Let's put her in gear. Let's make sure she's in sport. Yep, now she is. Ooh, the exhaust got a nice little rumble. So let's see here. Oh man, yeah, my summer tires are not agreeing here. All right, let's give her a shot, huh? I can barely hold the camera straight. Oh my God. I'm sliding all over the place. Jesus. It's been incredibly brisk today. I've been trying to figure out, the best way to make this fast for myself because I don't really want to freeze. So it's like, 24 degrees outside today. So it's pretty cold, like I said. If I missed any points and you guys want to know any more about the car, please let me know in the comments. Whew. But yeah, I was losing hella grip. So that's pretty much gonna wrap up the review of the RS7. It's cold, I need to go inside. I like to entertain you guys. I like to present what's going on in my life and tell you a little, about things that are happening. But like I said, guys, that's it for today. Peace, stay tuned for some more videos coming. It's all fun and games for 2020, baby. Let's go.